are back to business with 103.9 LA News Radio. My name is David Levenstein. If you're a business owner or professional, please contact me at my show at jvcbroadcasting.com. That's my show at jvcbroadcasting.com. I would love to hear what you have to say. I know all of Long Island will as well. My guest is Dr. Tommy O'Brien. He is the host of the Ask Dr. Tommy show, which you can listen to. What do you want?
Wednesday at 4 p.m.
Every Wednesday at 4 p.m. And talking to your mic, let me see if I can hear you.
Yes.
Okay, that's even better. Perfect, right. So every Wednesday at 4 p.m. So I want to talk to you about your business, okay? I want to talk about your business model because it always fascinates me. Medical insurance, health insurance specifically, is so expensive.
That's correct.
And the prices are going up.
Yes.
Are the prices going up because the insurance companies are looking to make even more money, or are they going up because people are getting sicker and the insurance companies need to pay for more people's health care?
Right. Well, I think it's more than one just, you know, reason.
Right.
One, they have to offset the what we call the Obamacare plans.
Right.
You know, the money has to come from somewhere.
Sure.
So they have to offset as well as its profit. You know, I mean, they're in business to turn a profit. Plus, you know, we're living longer, so that's a factor. Medication, the cost of living is going up in general.
And as people live longer, one of the reasons why is because of their health care that's available to them.
Yes.
Right. Yeah. So you offer a service to your community, right, that allows people that have high deductibles, that allows people that have no insurance, even like small companies that are not required to offer insurance to their employees, right?
Yes.
Their employees, they could be W-2 employees. They're on their own.
Right, right. Independent contractors.
And if you're a 1099, you know how expensive it is to insure yourself and your family.
Yes.
But what you do is you offer a monthly fee, right? That takes care of individuals or their family, right? For different monthly fees. You have different programs. And allows people access to you, right?
Yes.
As a family physician. And because you're an osteopath, it also, you offer a manipulation chiropractic services as well.
That's correct.
Right. And you specialize in pain management, you medical marijuana.
Yes.
So there are so many reasons why to visit your office.
Right, right, right.
Because of what you offer, not just the communities, but you offer small business owners as well.
Right, right.
An opportunity to have that relationship with the doctor that everyone hopes to build. And at the same time, something that's affordable to them. And they don't have to worry about co-pays. They don't have to worry about, am I annoying the doctor? This is you have a practice with a maximum amount of patients, right?
Yep.
Not thousands of patients, things
that.
I've met doctors that say that in order to have a successful practice, they need 5,000 patients.
Right.
And there's no, how do they manage that?
You can't. You just can't. You don't know your patients. You just can't. You're just a number. That's all.
Right. And that's what you don't want.
No.
You don't want to go into your doctor's office, sit there in the little room waiting for your doctor to come in, only to remember who you are because he looks at a chart.
Yes.
You want somebody to know you. And that's, talk about that aspect to your practice.
Yeah, sure. Well, my practice is called a concierge practice, and specifically a membership. And what is a membership? It's like going to a gym.
Right.
You know, when you go to a gym workout, you know, they charge your credit card every month.
Right.
Well, a traditional concierge practice is $1,700 to $3,000 a year, and they want that money up front.
Right.
So to help offset that financial burden, what I do is each month... You know,
like a membership.
Yes, like a membership, like going to a gym that we will charge your credit card, so it will spread that cost out over a year.
Right. Now, this type of business is not unique to you because you've done this in Manhattan for how many years?
8 years.
So you did it in Manhattan for 8 years,
That's correct.
You have an office out here in Suffolk County.
Yes.
In Patchogue.
That's right. And then a traditional practice will have, you know, let's say 3,500 patients.
Right.
For me, you know, I decided, I was thinking between 300 and 400 patients.
That's it.
I decided maybe 250 to 300 patients.
Right.
That's all I need. And you get that quality care that you really deserve.
No, you get more than quality care because you got a doctor that actually knows who you are.
Yeah, exactly.
You know,
I spend the time.
They call you on your cell phone. They go, hey, it's Dave Cohen, whatever. Oh, Dave Cohen, how's your back? How's your neck?
That's right.
Because you know your patients.
That's right.
You know that, you know, and you got that office in Manhattan, you got the office here, and this is the type of practice you built.
Yes.
Of helping people to reach their goals, which is everyone's goal is to live a long, healthy life.
Yeah.
No, your goal is not different than my goal.
No.
You know,
I'm a patient too.
Right, exactly. Right. You're not just a member; you're a patient.
That's right.
Yeah.
Just not the president, but
right.
I'm a member too.
I mean, people have short-term goals: lose weight, gain weight. You know, stop smoking, things like that.
Right.
Those are the short-term goals. Mm-hmm. The long-term goals. Everyone's long-term goal is exactly the same.
Yes.
It's to live a long, healthy life.
That's right. Quality of life.
Right.
Longevity.
Right. That's your goal. And if that's your goal, to live a long, healthy life, and you feel you need the assistance of a fine physician who's going to know you, know your family history, and doesn't have to get your information from a chart, Dr. Tommy O'Brien is the guy for you. Where right. can they find you?
Yeah, so I'm located in East Patchogue, 250 mm-hmm. Patchogue Yak Bank Road, East Patchogue, Suite 16, which is the garden level downstairs.
Right, right.
Like I said, East Patchogue, New York, 11772.
Yeah, what's the phone number there?
631-980-8200.
And the web address is?
Yes, you can find me at drtomio.com, drtomio.com.
Yeah, drtomio.com. Learn about his practice, learn about his specialties, and learn about how you can bring quality healthcare into your life and your family's life. And if you're a small business owner, which I learned this morning at our meeting,
yes.
A small business owner, you also offer plans and to show small business owners how they can
help their employees.
Help their employees and offer them the type of quality service that they actually can't even get at a standard PPO or HMO.
Right.
I mean, this is... And then the ability for their employees to build a relationship with a physician that actually cares
right.
and actually knows who they are.
Right.
Now, your background, I love your background. You are a captain in the Army.
Yep.
Right? You're a physician to soldiers going to action and coming back.
That's right.
Right?
Yep.
And you checked them out to make sure they were healthy.
Yep. And when they return healthy.
And that they return healthy.
Yes, yes.
So, well, what an honor that is to work for these soldiers, right?
Oh, absolutely. You know, yeah. It's not just the troops, the family as well.
Yeah.
And then, we had several stateside missions where we were helping the community as mm-hmm. well. So, it's not just the troops.
Right.
You know, it becomes the extended family, and then we right. get into the global family where we're helping the community.
Right. And people don't even realize how far Army medical officers really go,
right.
or the
right.
outreaches to their community around them.
Because we have more humanitarian missions than
right.
actually going into a live theater.
Right.
You know, and people don't realize that. I said, yeah, the Army, the Coast Guard. The Coast Guard's part of the military.
Right.
You know, after 9/11, you know, that was separated. Now they merged that.
Mm-hmm.
And what do they do? One,
right.
And you have ships out in the water and
sure.
in distress, they're there for
right. So you're out with humanitarian mission, not just the soldiers.
Yes,
is
yes,
it
yes.
the communities around them as well?
That's right.
So the Army really provides such wonderful medical service for everybody. You don't even realize what they do, but you can just go to drtomio.com, make an appointment, have a meeting, and once you meet this guy, I'm telling you, you're going to fall in love with him. You're just going to realize that you are in expert care that goes beyond. Really, any physician that I've actually met, you know, when you're a physician, you graduate med school, the first thing you want to do is, I'm going to make a lot of money. I'm going to join a big practice. This guy joins the Army.
Yeah.
Yeah, and becomes a physician for all the right reasons, not the wrong reasons,
right.
not to make a lot of money. You did it because you care.
Right.
You have a concierge practice because you care.
That's right.
You can make more money billing insurance companies for whatever.
Right.
But you don't.
No.
You run this practice because he cares. This is a person that actually literally cares about his patients. Visit drtomio.com and make an appointment. You know, just make an appointment. And his slogan is, if you wait, it could be too late.
Yes.
Yeah, don't wait. If you feel something, go see the doctor. Go see Dr. Tomio. If you hear banging in your car, you go to a mechanic. If you feel something, go see Dr. Tomio. Don't wait till it gets worse.
Right, right. Well, yeah. The key is that we want to be proactive,
right.
not reactive.
Right, right, right.
Set up a point. Well, let's do a history and physical, and then we do routine blood work,
right.
and then we get a baseline and see what we need to address.
Right, because as you do, right, when you, as the baseline changes, you know, well, there's something brewing.
Right, right.
Right. And again, it's concierge service. If he says, come next week, let me see you in 3 days, he's not charging you more every time you come in. You're
right.
not going to get another copay. It's a monthly fee. And you can really develop a relationship. It's not expensive either. A really develop a relationship with a physician that is so vital to your health.
Right.
I mean, to me, it's illogical to do it any other way.
Well, that's how it was before insurance companies, you know, got into the game. You know, if you go back, you know, how old are insurance companies? 1960s, 1970s?
I mean,
when did insurance companies really started? So what do we do before insurance companies? You paid the doctor, you know, every time you came in. Right. And it was what we call fee for service. You know, with again, mentioning the type of service, if I see you today and there's something wrong, you know, you have a follow-up office visit, and then we address the labs and see, you know, and how you're feeling, your blood pressure. If I find something positive, I'm going to treat it. When you come back the third time, it's not three $100 visits. It's only $100 for that entire month for the three visits or the four visits.
Or five.
That's right.
Whatever you need.
That's right.
All right. We're going to take a short break right now. When we come back, we're going to have more with Dr. Tommy. We're going to learn about his practice, learn about his specialties, and how he plans on treating his community. This is David Levenstein. Back to business. In a moment. And we are back. This is Back to Business on 103.9 LI News Radio. Again, if you're a business owner, please contact me at myshow@jvcbroadcasting.com. I'd love to have you on the air. My guest is Dr. Tommy O'Brien. His website is drtommyo.com. That's drtommyo.com. And you can listen to him on the Ask Dr. Tommy show, which airs every
Wednesday at 4 p.m.
At Wednesday at 4 p.m. right here on this lovely radio station. So let's talk about your practice, okay? Mm-hmm. Let's talk about the different modalities that you offer people as far as medical service.
Sure. Well, as you know, it's a concierge business model, which works. And specifically, I have a little twist to it so I can ease the financial burden by doing a monthly membership where you get charged on your credit card each month. And okay. I offer primary care. I'm a family physician, so I'm a board certified, residency trained family physician. Mm-hmm. Not only a family physician, I'm an osteopathic family physician. So I also offer osteopathic manipulative medicine. And the average person will not recognize that name because we focus more on the medical aspect, but you'll be familiar with chiropractic, okay?
Right.
The founding father studied under our founding father and decided to go out on his own and called it chiropractic. So to have a full understanding of what I do, I am an MD, an allopath, and a chiropractor combined, okay?
Right.
Our founding father was an allopath felt there had to be a better way.
Right.
And then he developed the concept of osteopathic medicine was a term that he chose, but the concept behind it, the principles behind it.
Right.
And he came up with a name. And then he, you know, felt there had to be a better way than, you know, just pumping drugs. And that's where he developed.
So as opposed to just being a standard MD, why is it that you went and became an osteopath? I mean, because it adds a whole nother dimension between, you know, when you go to your doctor now, your internist now, they don't provide chiropractic manipulative services.
Right.
But you do.
Yes.
So why did you choose to, you know, keep going into this type of practice?
Yeah. Yes, path. Well, originally when I was an athlete growing up, you know, I grew up here in Freeport, born and raised on Long Island. Being an athlete, I was very familiar with more of orthopedics and chiropractic, you know.
Because you got hurt all the time.
Yeah, well, injuries and more familiar. And
so did you ever think at one point, I want to be a chiropractor?
Yeah, no, actually I was at NASA's pre-chiropractic program. I was enrolled.
Oh, that's why, okay.
Yes.
So what made you change then to go into more medicine?
Well, I reached a point, you know, in my studies that I felt that chiropractic was just it was not enough, and the scope of practice was very narrow.
Right.
And then that's when I discovered osteopathic medicine, and I felt that, you know, it matched my personality. It gave me the opportunity to be able to prescribe medications, to do surgery. Since I'm not a surgeon, I didn't do a surgical residency, I can be a first assist or perform what we consider minor surgery,
right,
as well as manipulate. And I said, this is my personality, this is me.
Right.
An osteopath is the only complete physician. Okay.
Right.
When I say complete, I can prescribe meds, do surgery, as well as manipulate.
Right.
Chiropractors are limited to just manipulation.
But I think it's great because many times your personal physician, right, may send you to a chiropractor.
Right.
Only have to wait for the chiropractor's report to come back and things like that, right?
Right.
Where you are a medical physician as well as an osteopath, which encompasses all of those modalities, right?
Yes.
So you can actually look at both, and you'll know when the right time is to prescribe some medication, whether it be pain meds or sometimes it's medical marijuana is. And how does let's jump subjects a little bit, right? Because a part of your practice is medical marijuana.
That's correct.
Okay, so let's talk about what are the uses for medical marijuana.
Yes, I'll give you a little background there. Because I have a master's in nutrition, I take a holistic approach. And 8.5 years ago, a colleague of mine says, "Tom, New York State's we're going to be medicinal marijuana. You should consider this because it aligns well with the way I practice, natural." And I said, "I'm not sure." And then I started doing research, and I realized that California, since 1995, had medicinal marijuana. I said, "How come we didn't know about this?"
Okay.
So then I was one of the first to get certified. But I am the first to open up a practice in New York City.
Mm-hmm.
And I wrote two books on this. And they're Amazon certified number one bestsellers on the benefits.
What are the name of the books?
Medical Marijuana, Real Life Success Stories. And the second book is Holistic Healing.
Mm-hmm.
And that is the leading expert in modern medicine.
Right.
Yes. And that explains about medical marijuana and how it works and what we treat.
And what are the delivery methods of medical marijuana?
Yeah, sure. There's four delivery methods, and it doesn't matter what part of the world you are, four delivery methods. The first is inhalation. That'd be a vapor or the bud smoking a cigarette or a joint or, wacky tobacco, whatever you want to call it, right? And then the second one is what we call tincture or sublingual, okay? You put the oil underneath your tongue and then you just let it sit and it gets absorbed, and that bypasses the liver. That's why we do that. And we use other medications like nitroglycerin when you're having chest pain. That's where we put it. Or even a baby aspirin.
Under your tongue. Yeah,
that's right.
Sure.
So it gets into the system quicker. The third delivery system would be what we call oral. Even though sublingual is oral, they separate that out. Oral would be a pill, capsule, a gummy bear, lozenge, or even a tea. You can get the flower and have it in like tea bag form.
Okay, yep. Right.
And then the fourth and final delivery system would be a topical lotion or cream.
Right. Okay, so you don't get high from it. Let's be very clear. Mm-hmm. The THC is removed.
Well, no, we do have THC, but it's going to be it's just going to be limited, and we can control it. It's not like recreational. Recreational, I've seen an individual with a vapor that was 91% by weight by volume. 91%.
91% THC.
Yeah.
91%. That's like buying alcohol with 180 proof.
It's strong. That's someone who's been a recreational a smoker for a long period of time to develop that kind of tolerance to want to have that strength.
Right.
Now you're really getting into the psychoactive properties, so where you get the stoners high, you'll get paranoia, you can get anxiety, you get sedation, and you get the munchies. So you're gonna experience that.
So medicinally, the THC is controlled.
Absolutely. And it's probably right around anywhere between 15 to 25%.
Right.
Yeah. Okay. It's probably about the same strength as during Woodstock years.
Okay. So what is the what would be the purposes that someone would use medical marijuana for?
Sure. Qualifying conditions would be a cancer, chronic pain, neuropathy.
This is to treat the symptoms of those diseases. Not like with cancer, it's not going to cure cancer, but it may ease the transition between chemotherapy treatments and things like
right.
that.
Right. It could reduce some of the associated symptoms due to treatment.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we know THC and CBD, they do kill cancer. I mean, they do have anti-cancer properties.
Really?
Yes. Angiogenesis. There we go. Mm-hmm. Anti-angiogenesis properties where it decreases the blood flow there, and that's how it chokes it off.
Really?
But also we treat cognitive diseases. You have Lou Gehrig's disease. You have Parkinson's, seizures.
Right.
We have spinal cord injuries. So there's other diseases that we can treat and, try to slow the progression of the disease,
right.
but definitely reduce the symptoms like tremors and spasms, because CBD has excellent anti-spasm properties.
And in the last 45 seconds, one of your other modalities is pain management as well.
Yeah, so that's with, I use the pain management with manipulation and as well as with the medical marijuana.
Dr. Tommy O, visit drtommyo.com, drtommyo.com. Go to Amazon, Google Dr. Tommy O. His books will come up. They're best-selling books on how medical marijuana can be assistance to you in your life. And please go to drtommyo.com for a concierge service practice that will allow you and your family and your employees unlimited visits to Dr. Tommyo's office. He is only taking a certain number of patients. Once you get to that few hundred patients, he's done. So please visit drtommyo.com. Make an appointment today. Have a free consultation. drtommyo.com. My name is David Levenstein, and we have been back to business on 103.9 LA News Radio. Are you hanging on the edge of your seat? Out of the doorway, the bullets rip to the side of the beat, yeah. Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. And another one gone, and another one gone. Another one bites the dust, yeah. Hey.